Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpa, and this is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And as we see, the market has recorded a decent, or let's say, a big, I would say, intraday price decline. But in general, it seems that the prices of the major cryptocurrencies, they continue to consolidate. But definitely, the market is being under, let's say, bearish pressure. And yesterday I analyzed the price chart of Bitcoin, and today I would like to analyze a cryptocurrency that is not in top 20, let's say top 21 or something like this. For example, this is Polygon or Matic, because we have been analyzing mainly the top 20 cryptocurrency by market cap. That's why let's change a little bit our approach. And today I'm going to analyze the price chart of Polygon. So its current price is $1.08, and it has recorded a 4.6% decrease for the last 24 hours. So let's move on to the chart of Matic. Of course, we will start from the monthly time frame, but at the beginning, let me remove all those unnecessary elements. So this is the price chart of Matic. Here the price is 1.079. So let's start from the monthly time frame. This is the monthly chart. First of all, we had a solid price increase in the first half of the year. Then in June, a solid bearish candlestick formed, and after that a correction started. At the end of this correction, we had this, let's say, hammer. So it's a common trend reversal candlestick, and then the price rebounded and formed a bullish candlestick. But now we have another bearish candlestick. It has a local high above the previous one, but I mean above the bullish one, but its body also completely covers the body of the bullish candlestick. So the bearish candlestick engulfs the bullish candlesticks. That's why it's I would say a bearish signal, and we have to be really very careful. Of course, till the end of the month we have 3.5 more days, or approximately, let's say, 3 days. That's why let's wait and see what happens. But I would like to mention that probably this is a small bearish signal, and we have to be really very careful. In the worst case, or in some neutral case, let's say, we will see some kind of consolidation in the monthly time frame. In the worst case, probably we will see a decline to the lower bound of, let's say, this potential consolidation range. This is in the monthly chart. Now let's move on to the weekly chart. So this is the weekly chart. This is the price increase that took place earlier this year, followed by a correction. Here we had a rebound, and recently a bearish engulfing formed. So another bearish engulfing in the weekly chart, almost at the level of the previous local high. And here is the starting point, let's say, of this correction that we're experiencing at the moment. And here we see that we have mainly bearish candlesticks with descending local highs and descending local lows after this bearish engulfing. That's why we have to be really very careful, because it seems that in the weekly chart we have some bearish signal as well. Now let's move on to the daily chart. So here is the daily chart. First of all, I would like to mention that it seems that we have a sequence of declining local highs, but we still have an uptrend, and it means that we have a sequence of ascending local lows. And it seems that the price chart is starting to form a symmetrical triangle. Theoretically, it's a trend continuation pattern, so sooner or later, probably theoretically, the price is supposed to exit the triangle in the upward direction. So although we have some small bearish signals in the monthly time frame, in the weekly time frame, in the daily chart, if we have a look at the broader picture, it still seems that there is some probability, high probability, that the uptrend will resume. So let's cross our fingers for Matic. Also, let me add the three key moving averages. Because we're in the daily chart, I will add the 1 month moving average, or the 30 day moving average. Then I will add the 90-day moving average, or for the period of 3 months. And last but not least, we will add the 1 year moving average, or for the period of 360 days. So, these are the three key moving averages. We see that the price has dropped below the 30-day moving average and the 90-day moving average. So, to some extent, it's a bearish signal. Of course, these moving averages, they act as magnet and they attract the price. But we have to be really very careful because the price is at the moment below these two key moving averages. Also, they are moving sideways, confirming the potential, let's say, a consolidation or sideways movement. However, in case of some high volatility, I won't exclude some decline below, let's say, the trend line, and it may hit even the 360-day moving average, or for the period of 1 year, and at the moment it's at the level of 60 cents, 61, 62 cents. That's why we have to be really very careful. So now let's move on to the 4-hour chart, but here I will remove these technical elements. So I will hide the moving averages. And let's move on now to the 4-hour chart. This is the 4-hour chart. First of all, it seems that, as I just mentioned, if the volatility increases and if the bearish pressure continues, then the price may drop to the level of the 360 days moving average, or to the moving average for the period of 1 year. And in this way, it will hit these local lows, this one, and actually this is how it looks like. But now let me remove these technical elements and zoom out a little bit this chart. And I want to say that we had an uptrend here. After that, the price started to decline and it is forming a descending narrowing wedge. But at the end of the day, we have some kind of flag. If we switch to the 1 hour chart, this is the flag. This is the uptrend, this is the correction, and once again, we have this descending flag. What I want to say is that this flag is already deep enough and it's not like a, let's say, small flag. And that's why the probability that the price will exit the flag in the upward direction and resume the uptrend is declining. And that's why if the price chart continues its journey within this flag, I won't exclude this flag to fail. So this means this flag won't resume the uptrend. It won't be a trend continuation pattern. And in this case, definitely the price will continue its journey and hit the, let's say, the previous local low. And this is what I mentioned. It may hit these local lows. So, of course, this flag may, let's say, resume the uptrend. That's why we will keep an eye on this flag. But also it may fail because it is already deep enough. Now, let me remove these lines and I want to draw one important technical pattern as well. So, if the price chart continues its downward journey, I won't exclude the formation, let's say, of a descending triangle, like this. So, something like this. And then, during the next wave, I expect the price to resume the uptrend. So, this is also a potential scenario. So, fellas, that's it for today. Thank you for watching this video. Please share your point of view on the price chart of Matic as a comment below. Of course, I wish you a very wonderful day. Good luck in the financial markets, and I hope to see you in the next one. It was me again at CryptoSpark.